Hello friends, welcome to .NET programming tutorial. In this part we will learn how to create insert WSF service step by step. So let's start with tutorial. So first I will explain you how to create WSF service project here. So to create a WSF service project here, go to the file, new project. Now select WSF option here. And there is an option name as a WSF service application. Select this and we have to write the name here and click on OK. So this is how you can create the WSF service project here. So I have already created demo here. So to insert the record, we have to create the function under the interface here. Oh, this is the function here. Insert student detail here. And to insert the record in a table, we have to create the table first. So go to the SQL server. This is the student table here. Under student table there is a column name as a ID, name, department ID, gender, email and contact number. ID is set as a auto increment. It means that when record is inserted, then ID is automatically increment by one here. Then flip to Visual Studio here, and you can see that there is a class name as a student detail, and under the student detail I have written the get set property here. And you can see that this get set property name is matching with the columns of table here, and I have declared some variable here, and I'm passing this variable in get set here. You can see that. Now go to the service.svc.cs file here. So you can see that I am assigning this connection string to the string variable strcon. So this is how you can get the connection string dot from web.config file here. This is the insert function here, and before this you have to pass this class name to the in the this insert function here, and this is the object here. Now under this function I have declared string variable message here to return the message here, and this is the we can establish connection with database, and I have passed this string variable. And I'm assigning this connection string to the string variable here. And to insert the record, we have to write the SQL insert query here. And this is the connection object con here. You can see that. And to provide the values to this parameter, we have to write cmd.parameter.add with value here. And I'm providing this value to the parameter by using object dot here property. These are name, department ID, gender, email, contact number. These are the properties name here. We can access these properties by using this class object dot properties here. So I am providing this. This is how I can I providing this values, all this value to this parameter here. And this is the cmd dot execute dot non query. We use this execute dot non execute non query when we have to insert the record in a table. We can use this when we have to insert, update, delete the record in the table here. And I am assigning this result to the integer variable. If record is inserted, then it will return 1. If result is equal to 1, it means that record is inserted. Then I am assigning the message details inserted are successfully. If it is failed to if the record is not inserted, then I am assigning the message details not inserted successfully, and I am closing the connection here, and I am returning the message here. So this is how we can create the WSF service here. And to test the WSF service, we have to build first. Now solution built successfully. Now we have to test the WSF service here. So we can test the WSF service by using WSF test client here. So go to the debug, start without debugging here. So this is WSF test client here. My method name is appeared here. You can see that this is the method name. Click on this method and we have to provide the value here in order to test the WSF service. So provide the value here. Now click on invoke here. Click on OK. You can see that the message data is inserted as successfully. It means that record is inserted successfully in table. You have to check the record here. Go to the SQL server and you have to execute this select query. You can see that the record is inserted successfully in table. This is how we can test the WCF service by using WCF test client here. So if you like my video, please subscribe my channel, and to receive the notification, click on bell icon. Thank you.